guys, and welcome back to the Pig Room if you are new here. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Austin, and I own 10 guinea pigs myself. I have 7 girls and 3 boys. My 3 boys are right behind me. This will be the backdrop for today, so you guys will see them gnawing on the bars quite some bit throughout this video, so I apologize for that. But today, we are going to be filming, or I'm going to be filming, a really exciting video for you guys. It's been something that I've been wanting to get around for quite some time now, so I'm really glad to be doing it now. I feel like I'm a lot more educated about it because I've done it for so long. Fleece has been something that's been in this community for quite some time now. I actually used to use fleece for my own guinea pigs back when I had them in middle school. I actually discovered it from a channel here on YouTube by the name of Piggy Pig Pigs. I'm not really sure if she still makes videos, but she was the first person that actually introduced me to having the idea or the thought. Now, I just want to make a quick disclaimer before I start today's video. I'm not trying in any way to convince anyone to make the switch from traditional bedding to fleece or even to tell you guys that you are doing your jobs wrong as piggy owners. By all means, I am not saying that. I do understand that there's a lot of people out there that do own pigs, whether it be 2, 3, 4, even 10, maybe even 12 or 15, whatever, how many pigs you have. I do know that you guys probably do work outside of your own home, so you don't have as much time to spend with your own pigs, therefore not having as much time to clean their cages and spot clean and all the types of stuff that's involved with fleece. So again, by all means, I'm sure you take care of your own pigs, but this video for you guys is to just think about maybe even making the transition from normal bedding to fleece bedding and seeing if that would be a good option for you. Let's just jump right into this video and let's get started. The number one reason why I choose fleece as my main bedding source is just because bedding's expensive. I don't think I could put it any other way, honestly. And I think there's definitely a lot of variables that really dictate how much you're going to be spending on your bedding, and that's where you live, the type of retailers that are by you, and also how much of it you need. So it's pretty well known by now that guinea pigs should not be housed in any of the pet store cages that you see in your pet stores or anywhere else in the world. Those are way too small for your pigs to just thrive in and live their best piggy life and just be super happy. And it also should be known that pigs do thrive in pairs, so you should have 2 pigs. If you don't, I completely understand if you have an aggressive pig, but if you do have 1 pig and are just hearing about this now, definitely look into getting a second pig for your own pig. Just because they can suffer from depression and loneliness, it can actually, as a result, die from that. So it's really important that you do have a piggy friend with your already pig. So housing 2 pigs in those little small cages is not optimal. Thought of it's really nice because they are small and compact, and just buying a bag of bedding as sold in the stores, you can just see that, like, okay, maybe I can get about like 3, 4 or even more full cage cleanings out of this bag of bedding that I'm purchasing. Again, it's not the case. Guinea pigs need to have optimal space to live their best lives. They are runners. They just love to zoom around their cages. They love to popcorn. They love to jump. They love to interact. They love to play. And they obviously can't do those in those small pet cages. So you should be looking into having a CNC cage or even just a DIY cage. There's plenty of information out there with the minimum size requirements for the pigs according to how many you have. I do believe a 2x4 CNC cage is for 2 pigs. Working your way up with a cube longer, a 2x5 would be for 3. Now, I do not suggest only sticking to the minimum. I think if it's something that you can only do with the amount of space that you have in your house, apartment, wherever you live, by all means, that's fine. But I definitely believe in just providing your piggies the most amount of space with what you have. So if you are able to provide them more space, definitely do that. Now, considering that you guys out there have a CNC cage, my boys have a 3x7 CNC cage, which is a little over 3x7 feet. So it's pretty big for them. Honestly, I think it could be bigger just because I do catch them arguing quite often, but it's definitely bigger than what I had before. As you can see, this cage is just massive. So no type of bedding that I would be able to purchase in a pet store would be able to fill this up. I'd most likely have to buy 2, probably 3 bags of bedding, depending upon which one that I get. Now, you can buy bedding in bulk that's really, really cheap and is typically wood shavings, but I honestly, from my own experience and just personal beliefs, I don't suggest using that because guinea pigs do have really sensitive upper respiratory systems, so you can run the risk of having your pig get an upper respiratory infection, which is what I'm currently dealing with right now with Caroline and Wanda. Now, it's not because of that. I don't have my pigs on pine shavings. It's just Wanda contracting it to her. Again, my personal belief is that I don't think that we should be using them because of those risks, and it's just going to cost you more in the long run if you have to take them to the vet, which is super expensive. After finding out like what exactly it costs to take care of a sick pig after doing it myself, my mind was blown with the numbers. So if I can do something to like lessen the risk of them getting sick or developing any diseases or illnesses, I definitely will take that into account. Fleece is just a lot cheaper. You just buy it once, you can wash it, you can just use it over over and over again, basically. There's no having to go out to a store and purchasing it over and over and over again. I personally have been getting into fleece liners. I just actually bought a sewing machine maybe like 3 weeks ago, and I've been playing around with it. And I just find that spending even more time with the amount of pigs that I have, with scooping up bedding and putting into trash cans and filling it up even more and causing more waste, is just not something I want to do. Which leads me to my next point, and that's that fleece is a lot more eco-friendly. You're not going to be spending every single week just scooping up all this dirty bedding every single week, depending upon how dirty your pigs are. Females tend to be a little bit cleaner than boys, and then boys tend to be a little bit dirtier, so it is possible that you would be cleaning your cage maybe even more than once a week if you do have boys, and also the amount that you have. I personally don't want to be scooping up dirty bedding inside of trash bags and throwing that out, having to spend more time on my own pigs and cleaning their cages. With fleece, I just don't find it to take that long. It's really simple. You're just scooping up the poops and the hay and any other things that have fallen onto the ground and just throwing that out and causing less waste. I really just like having the convenience of just getting my fleece that's dirty and putting it into the hamper, going downstairs to the washroom, and just doing everything there, and then just having clean fleece. So it's super simple for me. Again, I do know that people do work jobs away from home, so they're usually out and about for like 8, even more hours. So having to spot clean is not something they can necessarily do in the morning before work. You do have to spot clean your fleece, which is one of the main things that you must do if you are using fleece, just because any types of poop that they're laying in, if it gets really, really bad, it can cause some, you know, harmfulness to your pigs and put their health at risk. So it is important, if you are using fleece, that you should be spot cleaning every single morning and evening. I sometimes even do it 3 times a day, obviously depending upon how dirty my pigs are. My boys over here, they poop so much, so I'm typically cleaning it about 3 times a day. Again, I work from home currently, so it's a lot easier for me to do that. Now for the third point, I just honestly know that my pigs love it so much. Pigs by nature love to burrow, they love to be cozy, they love to snuggle, they love to be warm, especially in the colder months. So just having something warm that's like a blanket fleece material as their bedding really does help in providing that for them and keeping them happy and healthy. I just know, just looking at my pigs and seeing how they just run in their cages, it's just something that they love so much. I honestly think that just having paper bedding inside of their own cages would be really difficult for them to do what they usually do every single day. My pigs get like random urges to just do zoomies everywhere, which is like running crazy around their cage. So having a really smooth and kind of hard surface to run on does allow them to do that a lot easier. Also, it's not just fleece that you have to stick to with your bedding. There are so many options for using fleece. I have pee pads, I have little Heidis made out of fleece, I have a microfiber rug. So there's so many endless possibilities with how you can use fleece. I actually just made a fleece florist. I actually just made a fleece forest for Caroline and Wanda, and they have been loving it so much. So there's so many ways that you can use fleece. It doesn't have to be just as the bedding. So your options are really limitless. Even better, if you do know how to sew, you're honestly golden, because you can just make so much stuff for them. And then my last point is that it's just a lot cuter. Honestly, it's a lot cuter than normal traditional bedding. I really just find that being able to go out to either like Joann Fabrics or Walmart and purchasing fleece, you can really just customize your cages to however you want. You can do it to your own piggy styles. If they're girls or boys, you can do it to your own aesthetic. You can match it to any decor in your room. So there's really so many options. I do know that a popular thing that people do is cage themes, and that's something I'm going to be kind of involving myself with in the coming holidays. So you can have so much fun with it. It's a lot of fun for me. Yeah, I mean, the fleece looks cute. It's adorable. And again, it's just really comfortable for the pigs to enjoy. So for the most part, you can purchase fleece from anywhere that sells home goods. I have checked my TJ Maxx, my Marshalls, for anyone that lives in the States, and they have a lot of fleece options. But I will say that I find that Walmart and Joann Fabrics are the main sources that a lot of people go to. Now, when I first started using fleece for my own pigs, when I first got them, which was a couple months ago, I would go to Walmart and actually purchase the fleece. They just come in 1.5 yard rolls, and they were about $6 to $8, depending upon if you got one with a pattern or not. So I was spending about $8 on a yard and a half, which is pretty fair. I do know that Walmart fleece used to be cheaper, so it wasn't that bad, but I have opted for Joann Fabrics now and just solely using their fabrics for a couple of reasons. One, I really find that it's a lot more convenient for it to come on rolls, and being able to go there and having an employee cut the exact dimensions of the fleece to your liking, just making it easier for lining the cages and cleaning them out, or if you're doing fleece liners and everything kind of pre-measured. Two, it's just a lot better quality, I notice. I struggled so much for some reason to wick my fleece from Walmart. I don't know what it is. I do know that you can tell that it's a lower grade quality fleece, but for some reason, I could not wick it. So I have now gone to Joann Fabrics and I went through the wicking process once with their fabrics, and immediately after, it just fully wicked. It was perfectly fine to use for their cages. I have actually changed my process for wicking my fleece, which I will show you guys today. So moving on to potentially one of the most important parts of today's video, and that is discussing how to properly prepare your fleece before it's actually put into your piggy's cages. Now, it's not as simple as just going out to your stores and purchasing your fleece and then sticking it into the cages. I wish it was that simple, but there's actually quite a few steps involved before you're able to do so. For those of you who don't know what wicking is basically the process of stripping away the outer layer on your fleece to make it absorbent. All fleece comes with a top layer coating to make it water resistant. For the case of the pigs, you do not want that whatsoever, just because they do pee, and just having that pee sit on top of the fleece for them to just soak in or lay on can be really dangerous for your pigs. I actually dealt with it with one of my pigs, Eris, and I used a improperly wicked fleece for her cage, and she developed a bacterial infection on her face because she actually ended up laying in a pee puddle. So that is just one of the things that can happen if you don't properly wick your fleece and you're sticking it into your cages. So when I first purchased my fleece from Walmart, I kid you not, guys, like, I went through absolute hell to just get my fleece to wick. I probably went through the washing and drying process about 7 times on one of my fleeces, and it still was not wicking properly. It did a little bit, but like when I would pour the water on top, it would obviously sit on the top, and then I would have to like press it down and it would eventually go down, but not entirely. And I was like, this is not right. Like, I'm not doing something right. So I jumped on the internet. I watched countless videos. I read all these forums. I came across this really random video. It did not have a lot of views on here. I'll try to find it and link it down below so you guys can actually see it, and I can also credit them. But I did find this one method through this video that was seriously a godsend and worked within the first go. When it happened, I was just so incredibly happy because I was to the point where I was just gonna give up and just stick with normal bedding at that point, honestly, because it was not working. So if you guys struggle with wicking your own fleece, I highly, highly, highly recommend trying out this method. Usually it will just work fine within one go. Sometimes it takes 2 goes, but it's definitely a lot better than washing your fleece 5-7 times. I just want to put a disclaimer out there, it may not work for you for the first go or even second go. All washers are different. So we're just gonna jump right down to the basement, which is where my washer and dryer is. I'm gonna be showing you guys a little demonstration in regards to wicked fleece versus non-wicked fleece. And then I'm actually gonna show you guys the process of wicking your own fleece and what I do and the ingredients involved. And then we're gonna move right back up here and then we will just finish off this video. So we are now in my washroom, which is in the basement, but I wanna give you guys a quick demonstration of what wicked fleece versus non-wicked fleece looks like. Just so you guys know, I made these liners last night. So it has a layer of fleece on the top, a layer of the U-Haul pad in the middle, and then a layer of fleece on the bottom. And then just for demonstration purposes, so you guys can see that it's the exact same, this is what it looks like if this were to be open. We have the fleece layer on the bottom, the U-Haul pad, and then another piece of fleece. This one's not wicked, this one is wicked. So remember, guys, as I mentioned before, the pee, or in this case, the water, should immediately go through the fleece and into the absorbent layer, leaving your pigs to be dry and not stepping on or laying on any wet surfaces. So I will show you guys what that looks like right now on both of these. So we are going to start off with the unwicked sample first. So just for reference, say this is the pig and they're about to pee. You guys will be able to see what this does. And you'll see right there, I guess I can move it right onto the green, that the water has not absorbed into the fleece. So this is a perfect demonstration of improperly wicked fleece. You'll see that it's kind of just pooling up on there. It's sticking to some parts, which is not great because your piggy will just be laying in this and getting all wet. Now moving on to properly wicked fleece. Same thing here. We have our liner right here. So our piggy just wants to go pee right there. And you will see the water absorbed right away. Now this will be dry and give or take probably a minute or two. You'll slowly see this kind of dark spot go right away and return back to its normal light green color. But just for demonstration, a piggy would be kind of like walking on this and stamping, and you'll see immediately that goes straight away. And right to the touch, it's completely dry. Now that water is in that U-Haul padding layer and leaving your piggies to not sitting in any kind of wet spots. So now that you know what wicked fleece versus non-wicked fleece looks like, I'm actually gonna be showing you guys the method I have found to properly wick your fleece. Moving on to the first ingredient that we use to wick our fleece, and that is a free and clear detergent. Now it's really important that you are buying a free and clear detergent when washing your fleece, because again, piggies have really sensitive upper respiratory systems. So it's really important that you're choosing a detergent that's
hypoallergenic, so there's no perfumes or dyes within the actual detergent. This will really make sure that there's no scent left on the fleece after washing it and causing your piggies to be irritated in the nose. There's a lot of brands out there. I just get this brand because it's usually on sale. I got like 2 for $4, which is honestly like a steal. Then moving on to our second ingredient, and that is just regular Dawn dish soap. This is really popular after we had that really major oil spill in the ocean, and this was actually being used and marketed for those types of situations. So it was safe to use on animals like small ducklings that were coated in oil. So this is 100% safe for your piggies. Now, it's really important that you're not using too much of this because it can get really sudsy and bubbly, so you don't want to just like have your washer like overflow of bubbles. So just a little bit of this goes a long way. And then our third ingredient, which is kind of interesting, you would never imagine to put this in your washer, but it is a absolute amazing thing to use, and that is just some regular distilled white vinegar. This actually gets rid of all germs and kills off any bacteria. So if you're washing new fleece, you really want to use this to make sure that all those hands that were touching it and the scent of the store are completely off after you wash it. And you can also continue to use this on future washes every time you do a load of piggy laundry. I absolutely love this stuff. It is definitely a lifesaver. And just making sure that your fleece is not stinky. I definitely use a lot of this for my boys because they are the messiest pigs ever. But yeah, these are the three ingredients. I'm actually going to show you guys a piece of fleece that is unwicked and show you guys what the process is of measuring everything and bringing it through the wicking process. So this is a fleece that I recently purchased from Joann Fabrics. This fleece is 5 yards, so we've got a ton of fleece that we're working with. It's really important that when you are washing your fleece, especially for the first time trying to make it wick, you're not stuffing it to the top. You need to allow some room for the fleece to actually be worked and to have the washing machine do what it's supposed to do on the actual fleece and get rid of the outer coating. So just make sure that your washer is about halfway full, maybe 3/4 of the way full, but nothing more than that. So we're gonna start off with our detergent. So again, it's our free and clear detergent. Because I'm only washing one fleece, if I was to be doing more, I would use a full cup. But for the sake of just doing one, we're actually going to do a little under half a cup. This will be just enough to actually get the fleece nice and clean and free of any smell. So we'll just pour that in right now, right on top, however your washer takes your detergent. And then we will be going in with our Dawn dish soap. Now for this, again, you guys don't need much of it. Just a little bit goes a long way. So kind of eyeball this. I don't really have an exact measurement, but just because there is one fleece in here, I really don't need a lot. So I'll show you guys how much I would use for this. Just like that much. Honestly, nothing crazy. And then moving on to our white distilled vinegar. I don't like to use too much of this as well, especially when it's just one fleece. The fleece for the most part is clean, so I don't need much of it. So I'm just going to do just about 3 gentle pours like that. And we'll close this up right there. And then we will actually move on to setting and starting the wash. So all of these settings are really major when washing your fleece the correct way. So your washers obviously vary in the layout of where these buttons are, but I will give you guys the general basis for how my washer is set up. So we have soil level, wash temp, what kind of cycle you want to run it through, rinse options, and then a pre-soak. For the soil level, we want to go heavy. So this is basically telling your washer that your fleece is really dirty. It's not actually dirty. Your washer is just going to put the items within the washer through a more intense washing cycle. So that's really going to help break up that outer layer. And then for the wash temp, we're going to put it to the hottest it can go. For this case, it just says hot. This too allows for the wicking process to do it within one go. The hottest water will get it the most clean and also break up that layer as well. And then for our wash cycle, we're going to go from normal to heavy duty. Again, we want to tell the washer to go really, really intense on our fleece and break it up and really swish it around. And then for our rinse options right here, just normal, one rinse. And for pre-soak, I like to just turn that off because I don't find it necessary. So we're just going to hit the start button and then that will run for 55 minutes. The fleece is currently in the washer, but I'm just going to show you guys the settings for the dryer. So I like to set the drying time to 40 minutes because again, it's just one fleece, so it does not need that much time. Typically, it doesn't even take this long, but I just like to really make sure it's completely dry. And then for the last knob, just make sure your temperature is set on high. So hot water, high temperature. Your fleece will shrink a tad bit after going through this process 1 or 2 times, but I like to actually pre-wash and pre-dry my fleece before I actually make my liners, just so that the measurements don't get screwed up and the fleece liners actually fit perfectly within the cages. Alrighty guys, so that is pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed that little demonstration. If you guys do try out this method, please let me know if it works for you. I want to hear your success stories, so leave them down in the comments below. I know that I didn't cover every possible thing that I could say about fleece because we could probably be here for a straight hour because there's so much to cover. But if you guys do have any questions for me or just any additional information that you think I should know, please let me know in the comments down below. I would be happy to talk with you guys and also answer some questions. But that's pretty much it from me. And until next week, I will see you back here in the pig room. Bye guys.